Welcome back to NHL Breakdowns presented by MapSouth Goaltending. Thank you for the support, and if you've missed any of our previous installments, they are posted on our Instagram and YouTube channels. This week we will be focusing on 2018 Stanley Cup champion Braden Holtby. Holtby has cultivated a very efficient and simplistic game, where he plays the percentages by utilizing his 6'2", 215-pound frame to maximize his coverage. This, combined with his renowned mental toughness, has allowed him to be a consistent presence as the Capitals' number one goalie. With him being a free agent after the season, and his track record as is, he will be highly coveted on the open market. Here are some of the highlights of his resume. He's a Stanley Cup champion, 2016 Vezina Trophy winner, 5-time NHL All-Star, 2 times he's led the NHL in wins. He was the 2016-17 Jennings winner for the lowest goals against average, and also won an AHL championship in 2010. Holtby flat out knows how to win. Now let's get into a tactical and technical breakdown, starting with his strengths and weaknesses in line rush situations. Holtby's first line rush strength is his efficiency. Because Holtby appears to base his game around box control, he often looks very efficient in the net. He manages his depth and does a good job maximizing his coverage as a result. You'll notice this as you watch his decision making off the rush. His second trait is his patience. Holtby does a very good job of beating passes on his feet, which is a byproduct of the previously mentioned efficiency. He does a good job waiting till pucks are released and keeps his torso upright and on top of the puck. Holtby's third trait is his mobility and agility. Just because he plays an efficient game doesn't mean he doesn't have great change of direction abilities. You'll see this on plays where they have multiple passes. His compact game allows him easy access to his edges and can change direction on a dime. His last trait is both a strength and a weakness, being his visual attachment and his box control skills. One of the downsides of playing a game based on percentages and compactness is that it comes at a cost of tracking and save selection. Shots that are located above his logo are often fended off with elbows and shoulders instead of using his hands. This can lead to poor rebounds, and because he doesn't maintain visual attachment, can lead to slower recoveries on situations where there's rebounds. Our first clip is a one-man attack with Kessel attacking on his off wing. Holtby does a good job establishing appropriate depth and sets his feet as the shot is taken. Notice his save selection on this shot, high glove. His glove drops under his chest and he uses his elbow to fight it off. Instead of catching that puck clean, the play continues and adds zone time for the Washington defenders. This shows the importance of trying to use our reactionary skills on these outside shots. Here's another one-man attack off a quick turnover. The Washington defender is feeling pressure and is looking to put the puck on the weak side of the ice. Krause of the Coyotes does a great job creating this turnover. Notice, Holtby is prepared for the worst case and moves off his post in a ready position. Krause fires a quick shot to 5-hole and Holtby seals and covers the rebound. Great job being prepared for the worst case scenario whenever the puck is in our zone. Our third clip is a partial breakaway with Matt Calvert of the Avalanche getting a pass with a step on the Washington defenders. Holtby gets out a foot past the top of his crease and begins his retreat, matching speeds with Calvert. Calvert changes the angle to his forehand, and Holtby begins to drive his knees to build his coverage from the ice up. Calvert tries to slip at 5-hole, and Holtby denies him with a solid knee drive and no holes along the ice. Great read, and good job pulling in his backside leg to prevent any holes in his coverage. Here's another partial breakaway with the Canucks attacker receiving a nice little saucer pass to spring him from the hash marks in. Watch Holtby as the pass is received. His feet are set, and he has a compact base, and is balanced if the shooter elects to shoot or make a move in the net. The pass carries the shooter to the strong side post, and Holtby's center shifts into an overlap position just in front of his post. Look how much space Holtby's filling. This is one of the benefits of utilizing box control on one-man attacks. The save is made, and the rebound is easily controlled. Nice sequence. Now we're going to watch a couple penalty shot clips against Buffalo, with a player swinging from each direction. Notice how his habits stay the same, regardless of which way the shooter is attacking from. The first is Sam Reinhart, and he swings out to Holtby's glove side. Holtby likes to be aggressive on these situations and gets out about 2 feet in front of his crease as he begins his retreat as Reinhart hits the top of the circle. He starts to lower his head and shoulders on top of the puck as Reinhart hits the hash marks. Holtby recognizes he isn't in a shooting position and holds his feet in balance. Reinhart quickly spins to his backhand and Holtby shows excellent lateral agility as he digs in and pushes behind the new angle and extends his blocker to make an excellent save. Now we look from the other side with Eichel taking his attack. He swings to Holtby's glove side and notice that Holtby's setup is identical. As Eichel swings to the middle, Holtby maintains his width in his stance, doesn't get too wide as he moves laterally, and matches with the change in angle with quick short shuffles. As the shot is released, Holtby half butterflies and kicks at the puck that is shot low glove. As you guys know, I'm not a huge proponent of this save selection, and you can see why. There's space 5-hole, his shoulders are off the puck, and he can't reach for shots just over his ankle on the glove side. The save is made, and I really like Holtby's pre-shot lead up on this sequence, and it's something that we can take a lot and apply to our games in breakaway situations. Now we're going to move into line rushes with multiple attackers. Here's a 2-on-1 with two of the most dangerous players in the league. Rantanen attacks the blue line on his off wing with McKinnon in a one-time position. Holtby is just past the top of his crease with his heels, which allow him to respect both pass and shot. Rantanen changes from a shooting position to make a quick lateral pass, which is a little behind McKinnon. Holtby tries to beat it on his feet, but realizes he has a little extra time because of the bobble, and he takes a secondary push to get behind the release. He's a little off balance, but he's able to make the save because of his good second push. Good read on a very difficult situation. Here's a 2-on-1 that turns into a 3-man attack when the puck carrier Connor Garland hits the brakes at the top of the circles. I love Holtby's depth selection with his toes at the top of the crease, which would allow him to get to either passing option. Garland gets time and space as the Caps defender blows a tire. As the shot is taken, Holtby has a clear lane to the puck. Garland fires the shot high glove, and again, Holtby shrugs it off with his shoulder. This will show the downside of blocking on these types of plays. The puck pops up in the air, and Holtby doesn't know where it ends up. As he recovers to his feet, he has little idea of where it ends up because of the unpredictable rebounds that are caused by a save selection of this type. Fortunately, the Capitals player is first to the puck. Had he tried to catch this puck clean and in front of his body, he would have been able to make the sequence much easier. And even if there was a rebound off his glove, because he can track it out in front of his body, he would have been able to initiate his recovery right away. Here's a goal against clip that will again show the pitfalls of playing a blocking style in line rush situations. Holtby makes a great save on the initial line rush of a backdoor pass. The puck is turned over, creating a second 3-on-3 after Dahlin makes a great play. The pass is made to Olofsson. I like that Holtby beats it on his feet, but watch the path of his glove. He drops his fingers thinking he was going to use his elbow to make the save, but as he recognizes the shot getting up and outside his coverage, he is late reacting with his glove. Watch on the replay. His glove goes down and then up. Against a shooter like Olofsson from this proximity, there is no chance of getting to the puck with two movements. It needs to be a straight line right from his stance or butterfly. The shot still may go in because it is so well placed, but this gives us the best chance on these situations. We need to try and be reactive. Here's a 3-on-3 clip with the brinkhead of the Blackhawks cutting to middle ice. A couple things to watch here are the change of direction ability, Holtby's ability to lead with his head and eyes, and how patient he is in holding his edges. DeBrincat is in a dangerous shooting position and makes a pass to Taves, who immediately one-touches it back to DeBrincat. Because of his good head and eyes, Holtby doesn't panic when he realizes he's a little behind the initial pass to Taves. A lot of goalies would have slid, and they would have had no chance to recover. He quickly gathers his balance and loads up on his blocker side leg to push back for a quick shot from DeBrincat. Great job by Holtby changing directions on this play two times before thwarting a stellar grade A from the slot with a good elbow save. This is our final line rush clip, and I love this sequence by Holtby. It starts on a power play zone entry where the Avalanche are attacking. Rantanen enters the zone and quickly pulls up. Look at Holtby's head and eyes. As soon as he recognizes Rantanen pulling up, he is scanning to determine the next pass. Rantanen kicks it to Burakovsky in the middle, who quickly distributes it to McKinnon in a one-time position. Holtby beats the first pass to Burakovsky and through traffic finds a sight line, right as the pass is made to McKinnon. He snaps his head and eyes to his next destination and does a great job moving through the middle of the crease for the shot. He delays his slide so he doesn't overshoot this final destination. Watch on the replay and look at Holtby's head and eyes on this puck as he tracks it into his glove. Excellent sequence and a lot of important details that can be implemented into our own games. Now we're going to shift our focus to in-zone above-the-line plays. We're going to start by talking about a couple traits that Holtby has that we'll be focusing on. Holtby's first trait that we're going to focus on is his play reading skills. He does a great job in these situations understanding where all passing options are. He does a good job using his relaxed stance when the puck is on the perimeter to broaden his scope. He frequently makes the correct read as a result. Holtby's second trait is his patience. This builds off his ability to read the play, as he often beats passes on his feet. This is typically his first instinct, and if he feels he can't get there by trying to beat it on his feet, he'll perform what I call a delayed slide to control the distance he travels. Holtby's third trait is his lateral movement. As we touched on during line rush, Holtby's a pretty good athlete. He does an excellent job changing directions quickly and efficiently. As you'll see, he maintains his compact stance, which affords him balance and access to his edges at all times. The last trait we're going to focus on in above-the-line situations is both a strength and a weakness, and it's his head and eye habits. I feel like he does an excellent job with these during his pre-shot movements, but he frequently reverts to blocking and not maintaining visual attachment as the shot is released and following through the save cycle. Be sure to note these habits during the analyzed clips. Our first play starts with McKinnon hitting the second wave attacker, Cale Makar. Holtby beats the initial pass on his feet, taking an excellent path through the middle of the crease. As Makar slides laterally. Holtby does a good job using short shuffles to maintain his angle while fighting traffic. I also like that he keeps his toes inside the top of this crease, managing his depth well. Makar gets into a shooting position in line with the faceoff dot, and Holtby is in perfect position. Makar shoots back against the grain, high glove, and notice Holtby's head and eyes and save selection. He shrugs it off with his elbow, creating a rebound up the middle. He's able to recover and fights off the second shot from the crashing D-man. But let's think about this critically. How would this situation played out had he tried to track and catch it clean? I feel like it could have prevented the second opportunity. He put himself in a good position to be reactive with excellent pre-shot movement, and a better save selection could have made his life easier. Now we're going to look at two power play goals to highlight the importance of visual attachment, which we just touched on two one-time situations. It isn't enough to just get there and fill space, quote-unquote. This isn't to pick on Holtby. We just want to think critically to try to apply correct habits to our own game. The first is a Vancouver 5-on-3 with JT Miller rolling up top and then heading downhill towards the net. Holtby does a great job battling for a line to the puck. He gets in his ready stance, and the pass is made to Pettersson on the flank. I love that Holtby beats it on his feet. He leads with his head and eyes and is in a good position as the puck is released. The shot is a bomb high glove, and look at Holtby's position. He's on angle, and he built his coverage from the ground up, but he tries to shrug off this puck with his head and eyes still forward. He gives himself a much smaller chance of making the save based on the shot location by just throwing an elbow at the puck. The shot may have gone in based on proximity and where it ends up in the net, but we want to enforce good habits in order to give ourselves the best chance on every puck. This next power play goal is another one-timer, but it's from a little further out. Spurgeon passes from the top to Fiala at the flank, who is located at the top of the circle. Holtby's pre-shot movement is excellent as he gets there on his feet and beats the pass with his head and eyes. The shot goes high glove just over his shoulder. Watch on the replay. He has a clear lane to the puck, and as the puck travels past, look as he pulls his head and eyes off the puck. He doesn't take a straight line to the puck with his glove either. It's kind of a circular motion as he drops it and then tries to swing up to catch it. And no, it doesn't deflect off the penalty killer stick. I've watched the replay on numerous times and trying to slow it down. It stays on the same plane off the stick blade. Both these clips are a great breakdown as perfect pre-shot movement can put us in a position to make the save, but if we don't execute the full save cycle, it can result in the goal. This is an excellent sequence of Holtby staying in control and making a couple great saves on a 5-on-3 penalty kill against the Lightning. The pass goes from Stamkos to Johnson, who takes a quick shot. Even though it is a bang-bang play, I love that Holtby beats it on his feet and fights it off to the corner. Holtby then tracks it on his feet as the play moves to his glove side. A pass is made out through the slot to a Lightning player attacking towards the net. Holtby's head and eyes track it the whole way, and he explodes out on his feet through the middle of his crease, getting on angle early. Johnson winds up and takes a bomb from the slot. Holtby is compact and ready to react and makes an outstanding save. Great sequence in a very difficult situation, and because of two great saves, Washington is able to clear and negate this 5-on-3. Here's another quality clip by Holtby after a quick Washington turnover. Landeskog gets the puck on the wall and hits Donskoy coming through the high slot. Holtby pushes out on his feet and takes a great path to get on angle early. The shot hits Holtby high in the chest, and he's able to control the rebound by pulling his glove underneath to trap the puck. Great agreed to be ready for that quicker turnover and also control this rebound. I would caution most goalies about not setting their feet as it could lead to rebound issues, but Holtby does a great job controlling pucks that hit him in the frame. Here's another penalty kill clip with the Sabres being on their own power play. This is some great puck movement, and I want you to watch Holtby's excellent decision-making and pre-shot habits. The puck moves up to Dahlin, and Holtby utilizes his relaxed stance to find the puck through traffic. He leads with his head and eyes as the puck is moved to Eichel, who then quickly one-touches it to Olofsson. Watch how efficiently Holtby changes directions. Most goalies would have slid on that one-touch pass, but not Holtby. He tries to get there on his feet and delays his slide, and his timing is impeccable. Great save, and he follows the rebound right to the corner to finish the save cycle. Here's another Sabres power play who show a different look, starting with a high-to-low pass and then a quick pop pass to the middle. Despite the different look, watch Holtby's process as he still shows excellent trust in his lateral mobility and has great head and eye habits throughout. Eichel makes a quick high to low pass to the net front attacker. Holtby understands that he isn't an immediate shot threat as he's not facing the net, and Holtby leads with his head and eyes and gets there on his feet as the pass is one touch to the middleman. Holtby gets out on his feet and times his butterfly perfectly on the quick release. Unfortunately, Washington can't clear the rebound out of the zone, but it was a great save nonetheless. Had he slid on the first high-to-low pass, he would have been in big trouble on that one touch. Excellent pre-shot movement makes the save look routine. This clip really highlights Holtby's excellent lateral movement skills. Kucherov gets the puck on the high slot and fires a quick pass to Stamkos in a one-time possession. Holtby is in a good balanced stance with his toes just inside the top of the crease. He does a delayed slide in anticipation of the Stamkos one-timer, as I think most of us probably would if we saw Stamkos winding up for a one-timer. He then makes a great pass to Hedman up top. Even in this fast-developing play, Holtby tries to recover to his feet. I really like those instincts a lot. Hedman takes a slap shot, high blocker that Holtby shrugs off. Great save, and that clip is very fun to watch and appreciate Holtby's lateral movement skills in a quick-developing situation. This play begins with the Hawks on the forecheck behind the net. Doc gets the puck and moves above the goal line and makes a great pass through the Caps defenders onto Kane's backhand. Holtby adjusts his path as Kane holds the puck with a great second push. He is able to gain depth and maintain his angle. Kane shoots a backhand and Holtby contains it at his body. Great job by Holtby recognizing Kane's patience with the puck and taking that secondary push to get his whole frame in front of it. Here's our last above the line clip, and it is a great save on a tip shot through traffic. A cross-ice pass is made to the weak side D, who makes an indirect shot pass to Pettersson's stick blade, who is attacking from the back post. Holtby recognizes that it isn't a direct shot and makes a great push and extends to Pettersson's stick blade. Holtby makes a fantastic save on an incredibly difficult situation. Good job showing ability to adjust and not getting tunnel vision on the puck. It's almost like he had an innate awareness that, or feeling that there was another guy sitting off the back post. Good awareness and athleticism. Lastly, we will move into in zone with a focus on low plays. Let's dive into a couple of the traits we'll focus on for Braden Holtby. Our first low play trait is his patience. This is one of the most consistent traits in Holtby's game, and low plays is no different. Be sure to watch how long he holds his feet before using RVH or other post play techniques. It allows him to adjust his feet and stay agile on pass plays. Watch and see why he's so effective in these situations. His next trait we're going to focus on is his box control and efficiency. Although I wasn't a fan of his percentage-based game on line rush plays that develop further away from the net, these tight situations are where it can be applied successfully. Watch Holtby get his frame on top of pucks with no opportunity for pucks to get through him or underneath him in these situations. Our third and final trait in these situations is his ability to integrate and exit from his post. Despite being extremely patient on low plays, when Holtby utilizes post techniques, his integrations are almost flawless. His points of contact are almost always in place, and it allows him to rarely get beat on dead angles and allows him to exit using leverage from the post to recover in his butterfly or on his feet. It's very fun to watch and learn. Here's a dead angle attack by Eichel. Watch Holtby as Eichel approaches the bottom of the circle. He is still holding his feet. He quickly tucks his glove side skate and locks an RVH with his toe, hip, and elbow and shoulder sealed towards the post. The shot is taken to create a rebound, and Holtby uses his stick to reel it in and cover it. This may look like an extremely simple sequence, and for Holtby it is, but that transition into RVH from overlap, to be able to do it that quickly and cleanly, is a byproduct of focused practice and quality reps. Goals from this location can't go in, particularly at the NHL level, and good habits and practice help Holtby avoid letdowns on these dead angle situations. Here's a Blackhawks power play. The play starts with a point shot through traffic that goes wide and is retrieved by Duncan Keith, who rims it down low. Saad picks it up off the dasher, watches Holtby utilizes his windows and tracks from his feet. Even as Saad makes a quick spin move and heads towards the net, Holtby demonstrates his patience. The pass is made to Kubalik, and Holtby is still holding his feet. He does a good job of rotating his blocker side skate to get a little more square to the puck. He drops into a butterfly lean. Look how much space he is filling on this shot. This is effective use of box control. The rebound comes out to the point, and Holtby uses the post as leverage to bump out on his feet, readying for the next attack. Here's a quick jam by Ristolainen of the Sabres. In this clip, watch Holtby's patience and excellent seal. This play starts with a blind pass thrown through the middle of the slot. It comes to Ristolainen, who pinches and attacks from the point to behind the net. He gets past the glove side post, and watch Holtby hold his windows and does a great job of holding his feet, waiting for Ristolainen to make a decision to attack strong or weak post. Feeling pressure from Orlov, Ristolainen attacks the strong side and tries to beat Holtby with a quick jam. Excellent technique by Holtby to get sealed and bring his blocker side knee down in case of a jam to the five hole before anchoring and leaning to the post. Great sequence on a simple play, and really fun to appreciate how easy Holtby makes his life on low plays. Here's a goal against clip that shows the importance of maintaining our coverage along the ice on short rebounds and low plays. It's one of the few times where Holtby gets beat in a situation like this. The puck is rimmed, and Fiala of the Wild does a great job keeping it in and moving it high to low to Parisi. Holtby does a good job with his timing of in his slide into RVH and makes a good first save on the stuff play. The rebound pops out about 6 inches from Holtby, and Parisi bangs it home five hole as Holtby tried to anchor himself by pulling up his blocker side skate. On this replay, you can see on these short rebounds, we would benefit from keeping our coverage tight as Parisi has pressure on him and really can't pull the puck laterally on this rebound situation. Again, it just shows the importance of sealing the ice when there's short rebounds around our crease. Now we're going to look at a couple of pass outs, and Holtby really shines on these plays. The first play starts with Arizona getting the puck at the goal line. Holtby holds his feet until the Coyotes attacker is about a stick length from the net. A good decision. Holtby leans into RVH, and I don't think it was necessary for him to lead with his stick with no immediate pass out in front of the net or the weak side. The pass is made to Fisher, who one-times it on the strong side. Holtby does a great job to bump off the post and absorbs it in his chest. Great sequence and played nearly to perfection by Holtby. It's a good for us to learn in terms of timing and path off our post in these pass out plays. Here's another pass out by the Avalanche. Again, it's a strong side pass out from below the goal line. The puck is cycled down low, and the Avs player has it on his backhand near the boards. The pass is made, and watch the subtle move Holtby makes towards the puck. He doesn't stay flat towards his goal line or push towards the middle of the crease from his post. He makes a tiny move to square his frame to the puck to play the highest percentage. He fights off a shot high blocker and maintains visual attachment, and he's able to bat it away, and his teammates are able to gain possession. This clip highlights high hockey IQ and good decision-making on a strong side pass out. This clip is a series of broken plays that shows Holtby's ability to adapt while staying in control. The play starts off the rush with Stamkos trying to hit a streaking Killorn down the middle, and the puck is then shot from a dead angle by Hedman. Holtby does a nice job getting into overlap position for the quick shot by Hedman. The puck is deflected, and Holtby does a good job tracking it as it floats over the net. I don't advise the 360 spin, but it does allow him to track the puck the whole time. He quickly gets attached to his post, and the pass is made to Cirelli in the slot. Holtby makes a great save and a compact butterfly. Cirelli jams at the rebound, and Holtby extends, and notice the path that he takes with his pad. It is back towards the post so Cirelli can't get outside his coverage. This takes a tremendous flexibility and strength, and then Holtby gets a secondary push to get his whole body sealed towards the post. Great sequence on a series of odd positions, and Holtby looks in control throughout. We explored a similar clip in above-the-line plays that showed Holtby's ability to react and be prepared for the worst case when the puck is in his zone. And he does so here, but in closer proximity to the net. The puck is below the goal line, and Arizona forces a quick turnover onto Kessel's stick. Watch Holtby get a quick C-cut off his post to gain some depth and get on angle. Kessel fires a quick shot, and Holtby fights it off because he's filling up the appropriate space utilizing his box control habits. Good job preparing for worst case, and is a good teaching tool as even the players at the highest level, the NHL, have turnovers, and our job as a goalie is to be ready to react at all times. Here's our last Holtby clip and highlights his intuition and ability to get into RVH quickly and effectively. The play starts with a line rush with Kubalik firing a shot low blocker, which Holtby steers nicely to the corner. Two shots are then fired and blocked, and the puck goes behind the net with Saad recovering it. Saad makes a great pass back against the grain to Kampf, who is ready to shoot a quick release from a bad angle. Look at Holtby leading with his blocker side edge to get linked to the post, showing his great intuition. Holtby quickly rotates to get his upper body to the post and makes a solid save. Kampf tried to throw a quick pass back out front, and Holtby's great stick position deflects it and allows him to recover. From there, he shows excellent edge work and his ability to change directions two times and get back to his post as the play goes behind the net. The play moves up top, and he smartly recovers from his feet, ready for the next attack.